As I've said, there is always an error in an experiment. Meron talagang always error yan. Sir, bakit ba yung isa napakalayo ng uncertainty, pero yung isa napakunti yung uncertainty natin? Ano ba yung nagko-cause ng uncertainties natin sa ating measurement? That is caused by errors. So, ano ba yung mga errors natin when we conduct an experiment that will cause the uncertainty of our measurement? Una, systematic error. So for example, meron tayong true value here. True value. This is the bullseye. The true value. Now, instead of tatamaan mo always yung true value, consistently, ang tinamaan mo mali. Yan. Yan ang tinatawag natin na consistently wrong. So for example, the true value is 100. And if your data is consistently wrong sa 100, consistently above, that is what we call systematic error. So, ang systematic error ang cause kung bakit mababa yung accuracy natin. Bakit hindi natin tatamaan yung bullseye? Second, we have random errors. Now, when we talk about random errors, if systematic error is consistently wrong, random errors are random, as the term suggests. Ibig sabihin, for example, the true value is 100 degrees Celsius. Tapos ang nakuha mo sa trial 1, 102, which is above. And then 99 naman, below na naman. And then 97 na naman, below. For example, trial 4 na naman, 101.2 degrees Celsius. Above na naman. So basically, hindi siya consistently above, hindi din siya consistently below. Random siya. So hindi siya consistent. Yan, random. That is what we call random errors. That means it reduces the precision. So basically, for example, bigay natin summary nito. Summary. For example, we have a data. We have a true value, for example, of 100 degrees Celsius. 100 degrees Celsius. We have group 1, and we have group 2. Ang group 1, ang nakuha na value ni group 1 is, for example, 90 degrees Celsius. Second trial, 91 degrees Celsius. Third trial, 91 degrees Celsius. Fourth trial, 90 degrees Celsius. If you notice, consistently wrong ang kanilang data. Consistent nga, mali naman. Do you follow? This is what we call systematic error. Now, what if we have group 2? Ang nakukuha ng group 2 is always is 101 degrees Celsius above sa 100. Merong 99 degrees Celsius below. And then 98 degrees Celsius. And then 102 degrees Celsius. Ibig sabihin, hindi siya consistently above or below. Pero there is something wrong. May isa above sa 100, may isa below sa 100, then below ulit sa 100, and then above ulit sa 100. This is what we call random errors. Now, what are the sources of those errors? Una, the precision of our instrument. Anong ibig sabihin yan? Kahit anong gagawin natin, our instrument will always give us different results. Okay? So for example, gagamit ka ng instrument na to, trial 1, tanda ka different trials, careful kay ka, so 14.41 millimeters ni gawas. Now, of course, you are a good experimenter, so you conduct different trials. Trial 2, tanda ka trial 2, and the trial 2 is 14.49 millimeters. And then trial 3, 14.43 millimeters. Nah, bakit may mali? There is something wrong. Bakit iba-iba yung results na binibigay ng aking instrument? Okay, so hilak na po kasi ako. Sir, ganun, mali ang awang instrument, sir. Kay lahi-lahi ang ginahatang measurement. No, mali. That is what we call the precision of your instrument. Kasi yung instrument, meron talaga yung uncertainty. Do you remember our discussion with significant figures? The last digit is the estimate, uncertainty. So pati yung mga instrument, hindi yan perfect. Meron talaga yung level of uncertainty. And that is acceptable because that is consistent. Tingnan mo, consistent sila sa isa't isa. Points lang yung difference. However, if nag-conduct ka ng force trial, tapos sa force trial mo ang lumabas, 18.12 millimeters, of course, you know there is something wrong with the force trial. Tama? Ang tawag natin dito, outlier sa data. So, disregard. Repeat another experiment. You just get the average. Kasi marami yan. So, just get the average. Okay? Because that cannot be omitted. May mali talaga. Meron talaga yan. Hindi mo yan maiiwasan. So, just get the average. Pwede din kasi iba-iba kayo ng reading ng mga groupmates mo. Kasi magsinumbagay mo diha kay lay-lay mong reading. And this is another example of a source of error. We have inaccurate calibration. For example, the true value is 97 grams. That is the true value, 97 grams. And you measure that using two scales. Una, si group 1. This is group 1. And meron din tayong group 2 later. So group 1, conduct ng experiment si group 1, trial 1, 98 grams. Trial 2, 96 grams. Trial 3, 97 grams. Average, 97 grams. So if you notice, taas-baba lang siya sa true value. Tama? This is what we call a random error. Just get the average. Ito yung sabi ko kanina na precision of your instrument. You just get the average. Okay? So, okay lang yung result ng group 1. Now, what if si group 2? Ang problema sa group 2 is there is something wrong with their instrument. Their instrument is not working properly. So, the same pa din yung experiment. True value is 97 grams. So, ang results ng group 2 always 142 grams. 146 grams, 140 grams. Muna yung result sa group 2. Okay? So there is an error. Bakit error yan, sir? Kasi inconsistently above the average. If you notice, mali talaga. Bakit? Kasi there is something wrong with their instrument. Basin mo bumingon ang group 2. Hala guys, consistent kayo atong results. Yehey! Consistent kayo na perfect na taani sa experiment sa physics. Without realizing that their instrument is not working properly. Do you follow? There is something wrong with the instrument. So ano yung gagawin natin, sir? Paano mo malalaman na tama ang instrument? Kay basig ma-zero lang ka sa experiment, kay wala nag-function ang imuhang instrument. Dili na muna sala, sir. Sala, iha muna nimo. Why? Because in the first place, hindi mo chinek kung nag-work ba properly yung instrument mo. Then just measure it with a known value. There is always a known value of nature. Tama? Kagaya ng boiling point of water. Alam natin na 100 talaga yan. For example, you want to use a thermometer. How are you going to know if this thermometer is working properly? I-test ko siya with a known value. Magpabukal ko ng tubig, and then I will be measuring that temperature using my thermometer. Now, napabukal ko ng tubig. I will use this thermometer. Now, what if the reading of the thermometer sa pagpabukal ng tubig is 89 degrees Celsius, boiling point. So that means there is something wrong with my instrument. Tama? Another example, sa mass. How am I going to know if my balance is working properly? Did I measure it with a known value? Example ng object with known value, the coins, the peso coins. Ang piso kay 6 grams man ah. Ang 5, 7.2 grams. Ang gis, 8 grams. These are standards. Standards man ah. So that means, if I am going to check if my balance is working properly, i-measure na ko, mag-imbang kong piso. And if the reading of the balance is 6 grams, then that is working properly. Tama? So, ingani akong ginahimo pag mato, ingani ang himo pag mato sa palingki. Para i-check nimo kung nag-work ba properly ang ilahang timbangan. Magdala-dala ka og known value. Excuse me ate, before you are going to measure my meat, allow me to calibrate first your balance. Ah, how naka-eskila lang yung physics. So, measure nimo. Now, excuse me, Ate, I think this balance is not calibrated properly because it does not read the standard value. You follow? So before measuring something, make sure that your instrument is working properly. You follow? Kasi kapag hindi mo alam yan, there is a possibility that you will commit inaccurate calibration, scale error, systematic error. Okay? Next one. The zero error. For example, the true value, for example, is 30.01 grams. Okay, 30.01 grams. That's the true value. Before measuring something, make sure na your instrument reads zero first when measuring nothing. Okay? Pura good na kung magtimbang ka, for example, timbangan ni, nadiri ang zero. Of course, na may pointer, then one. For example, 1, 2, 3. Magtimbang. Okay? Before ka magpatimbang, of course, dapat make sure na the pointer is aligned with zero. Tama? Kasi kapag ka, before mo siya i-measure, for example, before ka namalit, ang reading is naasa ang pointer kay naadri sa gawas. Dari ang pointer. Of course, there will be an error. Tama? That is what we call zero error. So make sure na before measuring anything, you will make sure that the pointer and the scale are aligned. Dapat naka-align siya. Now here comes group 2. Ang group 2, mga nagtinanga. Nagtinanga ang group 2. Instead of having a zero scale, hindi naka-align yung pointer at saka yung scale, zero scale, before at the beginning. So ang nakukuha nila always na data is 37.78 grams, 38.01 grams, 37.90 grams. Hala guys, consistent kayo tong data guys. Perfect na ito sa itong experiment guys. Thank you leader. Thank you pa. Consistently wrong. Tama? Bakit? Kasi hindi nakaset sa zero scale. Musugot na ikaw, mamalit ka o isda. For example, mamalit ka isda, zero na, tapos one na. Tapos ang pointer, nag-start na siya diha. Of course not. Dapat before there is, lagi na siya daan sa zero. To avoid error that is caused by zero error. So what next? We have parallax error. When we talk about parallax, ano bang ibig sabihin ng parallax? Tingnan natin. Follow, repeat after me. Try lang para ma-experience mo what is the meaning of parallax. Look at your finger using your left eye. Yan. Left eye. And then switch to your right eye. And then, faster, titingnan mo siya left, right, left, right. Left, left, right, 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 left, right. What have you noticed? Kapag titingnan mo siya using your left eye and then your switch to right eye, the position of your finger changes, tama? That is what we call a parallax. It's happening always when we conduct an experiment. Ano ba dapat? Dapat kung mag-read tayo ng instrument, dapat eye level always. So hindi sa top, hindi sa bottom, hindi sa right, hindi sa left. It should be eye level to avoid parallax error. Okay? Next, environmental error. Environmental errors are errors caused by the environment. Commonly, ang hangin. That is why in analytical chemistry, you are going to use an analytical balance which is always enclosed. Naka-close dapat na siya. So that it will not be affected by the outside environment. Okay? Kasi kapag ka nag-measure ka niyan, tapos nakaharap yung electric fan sa'yo, error na yon. Okay? So we must be very careful. Now here comes the tanga group. Yung mga nagtanga-tanga nga group. Ang group 4, for example. Wala nila gi-close ang analytical balance. So ang trials ni group 4 ay nagtinanga man 2.9, 2.9, 2.9. Hala guys, consistent na po na itong data. Very good na po gayo ta. Pero naka-open man ang analytical balance, consistently wrong. Consistently wrong. Okay, let's proceed with the last error, and that is reaction time. Reaction time is the time it takes for a person to respond to a certain stimuli. For example, natay mga friends na kung mag-joke na karon, ugma pa siya makatawa. Alan, guys, habi di kayong joke ni mo gahapon. Naputay ba nga mga friends na wala pa gani nag-joke, nagkatawa na daan. That is reaction time. That is the time it takes for a person to respond. So for example, reaction time. First trial, back 8.92 seconds ang nakuha niya. Second trial, reaction time yapon, back 8.85 seconds. Lalahi lagi. Of course, because we have different reaction times. Tama? Masin rin, dali lang kayo makurat man. Ang isa, dali kayo. And then trial 3, 8.96 seconds. So different trials will be having different values because of the difference in our reaction time. You will realize that when you will be conducting titration, dyan mo marerealize kung gaano ka-importante yung reaction time. Sa isang iglap lang, papiyong lang kagamay, wala, zero na yung experiment. You will remember this discussion when you will be taking titration in college. So to end this discussion, this is a summary. There will always be uncertainty. As I've said, we want to know the truth, but there are uncertainties caused by errors, of course. And those errors can be controlled by us or it cannot be controlled, so uncontrollable by us, for example. We cannot completely eliminate uncertainty, but we can minimize them so that we arrive closer and closer to the truth by avoiding the errors. Questions? Questions? None? Thank you, everyone. God bless you.